And now we're back. Could you do your shit direct after all this time? I'll admit, it was mostly peaceful until that. Security procedures.
Project log. Dr. Victor Issa. We turned on the prototype today. The gravitational field around it began to fold as we long suspected. Complete reversal of gravitational pull was observed on dozens of loose objects around the lab. I'm setting up a meeting with the directors to propose a larger test. The prototype proves we don't need the original anymore. But further work is going to have to take place in space. Somewhere with abundant helium-3 and with a civilian partner. Someone with access to large-scale manufacturing resources and computational equipment. Engineering gravitational folds pulling the far side of the solar system closer to us? It's all going to be possible.
Project log, Dr. Judith Tatian. I watched the gravjet test from the moon today. It was the first time we were able to talk to the team at Nova Galactic directly. So many things were under wraps before, but now everyone wants all the publicity they can get. I'm already seeing proposals for manufacturing androids of drives, expeditions to Alpha Centauri and beyond. It's also overwhelming. Worrying. It could take years, decades, before we know what all these side effects of operating a grav drive can be. But no one wants to hear that right now. Like a bunch of pioneers racing towards the edges of the frontier without knowing about the grizzly bears in the mountains.
Yeah, that is a good point.
wonder what they stored here. I'm getting close to the good stuff, I can tell.
About this. And then that.
Fox must hate you.
How do you... So Wait a sec.
I never actually got to visit your labs back when we were working on the grav drive projects. Seems like ancient history now. Only thing we're doing these days is launching weather satellites. Guess this is as good a retirement as any. Now, Project Demeter, you want our help manufacturing scanners to better track these new meteorological patterns we're seeing.
Our guess is that the poles might be naturally shifting, causing some gravitational fluctuations that are throwing off our old models.
Why do you need the scanning tolerances to be so small? What are you trying to find? I just want to be sure. It's not like we're doing much these days anyway. The glory days are over. Why not give ourselves a challenge before they write us off in the history books?
I've remembered to pause for this one.
I know what I'm seeing, Victor. The data coming back from the satellites is very clear. It's the grav drives.
All those jumps from the moon. At this rate, Earth's atmosphere is going to start sputtering out into space.
Can the drives be fixed?
I'm working on some designs that should discreetly solve the problem. Under the guise of an emergency update to the fueling pumps.
We're talking about the end of Earth, and you're trying to be subtle about it.
Judith, the last thing we need is people losing faith in grav drive technology. That might be our only option.
To what? Are you seriously saying we should abandon Earth?
The timeline is under 50 years. A blink of an eye for a planet. But more than enough time for a human exodus.
And what do we tell people?
We say it's an act of God. One that science has found a solution for. Time for humanity to take its place in the stars.
You knew, didn't you? You lied to me.
I...
All this time, I dedicated my life to this discovery, Victor. And you knew we were going to kill off our planet?
You haven't seen the future I've seen. There's an infinite expanse of promise out there. A meteor could have hit Earth. A plague, another world war. Colonizing other galaxies secures humanity's future for all coming generations, across all time.
At the expense of our home.
Stop it, both of you. All that matters is building enough ships to get everyone off this planet. And we need to start now.
I'll draft up a statement. We'll need to address the entire international community. I'm sorry, Judith.
There isn't a planet in this universe that will be far enough away from you, Victor. We are never speaking again after this is over.
My name is Dr. Victor Issa, and if you're listening to this, then you probably already know the truth. I was young when I first headed the retrieval team of an odd gravitational anomaly on Mars, but I kept what really happened that day hidden from everyone except one other person. Even she didn't believe me at first, but I have no reason to lie to anyone now, so I hope you'll accept this confession, whoever you are. When I touched the anomaly, I experienced 12 days of lost time. I met myself. He told me everything that has since come true. The grav drive equations, the tests on the moon, Earth's atmosphere sputtering away because of what we had done.
But he also told me about a city thriving on a planet orbiting a distant star. Human culture, art, music, lifestyles evolving and shining brightly across all of space. What price would I be willing to pay for that future? Maybe you don't believe me. Maybe Judith was right and I'm just a coward who wants to believe his mistakes were justified. But everyone has forgotten about the real origins of the grav drive, this artifact from Mars. I hope you make better use of it than I did.
We caused it. It wasn't some terrible accident. Grav drive. When the time's right, I'd appreciate a chat. I don't got many friends, so if it, my past keeps showing up, I should get ahead of it. Yeah, this is...
Take a leap and start talking.
Right. When I turned 18, my dad used one of his many connections to get me my first real job. That, plus the magical Ko family name, meant I was shipping freight out of Aquila. There's a way to take the wonder out of space. It was working for that outfit. Every milligram of helium-3 accounted for. Timetables down to the second, too busy to ever really appreciate anything. Or even look up.
That sounds terrible.
And the pay? So, an opportunity comes by from the boss man. He says, run this job, don't ask questions, and there's a bonus. Hell, I was still just a kid. I knew I wasn't shipping some dried mangoes, but suddenly, God help me, it was fun.
Oh, this will not end well.
You think? So, more jobs started coming. And everywhere I went, suddenly dangerous people were much better armed. I'd hear about armed conflicts and civilian casualties. Innocent casualties. And I'd pretend that wasn't me. Maybe I wasn't smuggling weapons, maybe I was carrying something else. As long as I never open the boxes, I can keep pretending.
You know you didn't kill those people.
Not directly. And I'd tell myself they'd get guns from someone else. But in my heart,
probably would.
I knew blood was on my hands. Soon the boss man's relying on me, and the pay was nice. Never had a lick of trouble.
Sounds like they took advantage of you.
Yeah, but it takes two to tango. To this day, I don't know what I was running that last job. But it was tasty enough, a whole mess of Crimson Fleet jumped me at the rendezvous. Now, a sane man would have been scared. But I looked at my pissant trading skiff's dual cannons and shouted, "Oh, this is on!" Yeah, I blew up one of the pirates before they realized that I was out of my gourd. I managed to get them down to two left before every system I had was fried. I was done. And that should have been the end. But that's when the Rangers showed up.
Taking out fleet vessels with the skiff's cannons is impressive as hell.
I don't even know how I did it. Pure instinct. But it wasn't enough. And then the Rangers took them out, no problem. Oh, that's fuzzy, though. See, I passed out. Offered me a job. Mm-hmm. And by all rights, it should have been a prison cell, but Lillian, she saw something in me. And I took the job. And that's it. All my cards are on the table.
You aren't that kid anymore. You're probably a better person for it.
Well, after I hit bottom, I learned a lot. But the thing that scares me is Cora. I mean, I gotta tell her someday. Sometimes the way she looks at me, I'm not worthy of that. But to see that look gone...
When she's older and the time is right, you'll have to tell her.
Well, ain't that something to look forward to? Just so you know, all this... This is why Lillian is something else. And I really need to own that. And have a tough talk with Lillian. Tell her about that follow-through you mentioned. Cora's at an important age right now. Every visit counts. You can't flake on her. Well, for now, I like getting a root.
Thank you. Okay.
Take off, Captain.
Let's put this bird into space. Achieving orbit now.
Understand now why I asked you to come here? The artifacts unlock the secret of interstellar travel at the cost of Earth.
An easy trade, honestly. Why have one world when you can have all the settled systems?
Sacrificing Earth wasn't worth having grav drives. We lost our home.
Assuming we weren't going to lose it anyway. War, disease, famine, all the classics.
Don't you see? The power of the autumn. How many would have chosen Earth? And what gave Victor Eisa the right to choose for them?
You see the hypocrisy in what the emissary is saying, right? They don't want to rule
in the wrong hands.
If a bird wrong is time, someone other than a starborn made a decision.
Don't be a fool. The emissary and I...
For once, he's right. Don't do this.
Actually, I'm gonna side with the emissary this time. I'm siding with the emissary.
Thank you.
Well, can't say.
Buried temple. We'll be there.
You're lucky I'm a man.
Stay for a moment. You must have questions about what happens next. Won't be able to go to the buried temple right away. There are still other artifacts out there in the sun. You need to work with your colleagues in Constellation.
Will you be coming with me?
I'll meet you in orbit above the buried temple. There's always a final artifact in a specific temple. The Hunter and I agreed that whoever you sided with, the other would wait there. Expect anything and everything. Other starborn, human mercenaries and defenses, alien creatures under mind control. It's all fair game.
Why can't we go to the buried temple right away?
All of the other artifacts need to be gathered before the final one will reveal itself. I'll be bringing mine, the hunter will be bringing his, and you'll need to bring the rest. All of the ones Constellation can find.
Why are we waiting? Couldn't we attack the hunter now?
He and I made a number of agreements over the years. If you could even... We let him go. In exchange, he'll wait at the buried temple.
Okay. Bye.
Any day you make it through is a victory. Yep.
Okay. No. First, I need to go. Let's go see the Opportunity Rover.
There's a certain quiet wonder to planets like this.
How'd you find you?